again.
Hey guys, I'm back with another video for you. Today I decided to film you a tutorial based on this look right here. It's dark and it has sparkles and it's leaning more towards the New Year's, but the thing that's different about this video from all my other ones is that it's a collab video with my friend Lauren, aka Refined Fashion here on YouTube. She is awesome and we decided to, you know, figure something out how we could do a collab video that was well suited for the holidays, and we decided to do a New Year's look. Hers is simple and elegant and beautiful, and mine's a little more dramatic for those of you that like to play around with a little bit of sparkle. So, without further ado, this is the look that I created, and I really hope you guys like it. If you guys do, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. But yeah, that's pretty much my spiel. Any other comments or requests for videos, leave them down in the comment box and I'll get back to you as always. I just wanted to say thank you so much for your support. I hope you guys all have a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holidays, and I will see you in my next one. Bye! So first I'm going to be going in with my MAC Soft Ochre paint pot, and I'm just going to be putting this all over my lids with my finger with no rhyme or reason at all. You want to make sure that you are using a primer or a base of some sort though, just so that your eyeshadows will pretty much stay on all day and they won't crease on you, because eyeshadows crease no matter what you decide to think. And then I put tape on the edges of my eyes just to have a nice clean edge. But then I'm going to go in with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer and just work this over my crease, just above it, not really putting it on my lid at all yet, but I'm just putting this here because when you do, or when I do in this case, when I go in with darker colors, the darker colors are going to have something to fade into, and it just makes the blending process a lot easier. Next, we're going to take Makeup Geek Mocha Eyeshadow with a MAC 217 brush, and I'm just going to be blending this upward. So I'm putting it in my crease and blending it towards that bronzer shade that we had just put on. This is a different technique that I actually saw Crispy do a couple of million videos ago. I'll link the video that I saw down below. But I'm pretty much starting out my look as if I were doing a cut crease, and I'm just putting this darker color in my crease so that I can blend it up. And then after this, I'm going to put it all over my lid, but this technique actually made the blending process a lot easier, and I'm usually really impatient with blending, believe it or not, and this made it so much better. So then after I put it on the lid, I'm just going to keep going back into that mocha color and just layering it and making it as opaque as I want it to be. With darker eyes, with any dark eye look that you want to do, blending is going to be a thing and you're going to need to be patient with it, so don't you worry. Just make sure you're patient. Everything looks like poo at first, but it's all going to look better after, so don't you worry. And I also had another one of those blending brushes just at hand with no additional product on it, just so I could kind of soften out the edges as I would go along, and it all worked out properly. So next we're going to be taking Makeup Geek Coco Bear Eyeshadow with a Crown C412 blending brush. This is my favorite blending brush ever. I talk about it more in depth in my iMats haul video. If you guys want to go check that out, I'll have it linked in the description box. But I just decided to add a little bit more dimension to this look. This is completely optional, you don't need to have this color at all, but I found that it kind of added a gradient to it and made it a little bit warmer of a look. As much as I'm trying to venture out into the cool toned makeup looks, I wasn't quite ready for it today, so I decided to just add a little bit of warmth, and then I kept going back and forth with that mocha eyeshadow, and as you can see from this clip, from the last clip, it has progressed and it looks a little bit better. Not the best yet, but let's just all be patient, it'll look good eventually. After that, onto liner, I'm going to be taking my newfound love, like, hello, what rock have I been living under before this eyeliner. This is the NYC liquid liner, and I see Desi Perkins and Crispy talk about it all the time, so I decided to actually go out and buy it, and it was buy one get one half off, so it's like the world knew I was going to buy that eyeliner that day. But then I just decided to do a winged liner, nothing too dramatic, but I decided to only film one eye because I was having troubles with the other one, but I got it, I have survived, so don't worry. Next, onto the star of the show, I have this NYX glitter liner, and I'm assuming it's in gold. I'm not too sure about its real name at this very moment in time, but I'm just lining it over the black liner. I wasn't too precise to cover the black eyeliner. That wasn't really what I was looking for. That's not the look that I was going for, pretty much. So I just decided to put the glitter liner over it as best as I could, but I was just kind of winging it, and it ended up looking okay. After that, obviously, who didn't get it on camera? I didn't, but I decided to put on my favorite Velour Lashes and Wispy Sweet Nothings. They're the best, go buy them, just do it. Next, onto foundation, I'm using my L'Oreal True Match Foundation in the shade W4. Yes, I only have the bottle because I had literally gone out to buy a new bottle that day, so that was the only reason why I had it. But I'm working this all over my face with my Morphe G6 brush. This is the best foundation brush ever, 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 but I'm dotting it all over my face and just working it in. I'm pretty much speechless with this foundation brush. It is so great. I'm so glad I have it. It's awesome. Jaclyn Hill, you made me buy it. Obviously, you make me spend all of my money. Next, I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Sand 20, 20 Sand, whatever you want to call it. And I'm just putting this all over where I want to highlight my face. I'll be completely honest. I could have gone with my MAC Pro Longwear. I wanted a little bit more coverage than what this concealer was giving me, but whatever, YOLO. Anyway, I'm gonna go in with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and I'm just gonna powder and set the majority of my face. I'm not really being too precise with it because I do go back in with another powder to, you know, intricately set my under eye concealer because it'll move and it'll slip and it'll slide and it's gonna be a hot mess. So don't you worry, I will deal with it in a second. When I go in with my Anastasia contour powder in Banana, it is awesome. If you guys don't feel like buying the entire contour kit, Anastasia does sell the single refill pans individually, so you can buy those instead. After that, we're going to be putting some eyeshadow on the lower lash line. I did mix Cocoa Bear and Mocha. That's why there's like an awkward in-between star. That was a really good clip. I think we should replay it. Let's talk about it later. It's okay. But my point being is that I'm just going to be smoking up my lower lash line as best as I can. For some reason, this glitter was kind of irritating my eyes. I think I had gotten some of it in my eyelid, and that's why literally from this point on, my eyes are so bloodshot, which kind of sucks, but I really, really, really liked the way this makeup tutorial had turned out. But I'm pretty much lining that as close to my lash line as possible, just so it can, you know, add a little bit more smokiness to the eye look without looking too randomly dark everywhere. I was just kind of making it proportionate. And then I'm going to be lining my waterline with a nude eye pencil and then coating my bottom lashes with mascara. Next, we're going to be bronzing up my face with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I felt like smelling the chocolate in this bronzer today, so that's why I decided to use it all over my face. So I'm just going to be contouring my face in the hollows of my cheeks, along my hairline, in my forehead, everywhere pretty much. I'm looking so pale, so literally any bronzer that I can get, I put it all over my face because that's just the right thing to do with bronzer. And then I'm going to be further highlighting my eyes, face, whatever you want to call it, with my Bare Minerals brightening concealer in Well Rested. This thing is awesome. Like, where have I been? What rock have I been living under when this product has been on the Sephora counters for forever and I've always just literally passed it and I've been like, meh, it doesn't look like anything exciting to me, so I'm so glad I picked it up. But then after that, I'm going to be putting on some blush, and I'm using my Becca Damselfly blush, and oh my god, this color is so beautiful. It is a little bit too pigmented, if that's even a thing, but yeah, just be careful, use a light hand with it. And then I'm going to be highlighting the highest points of my face with my Becca highlighter in Moonstone, and this is another, like, literally I didn't even have to use it for very much time and it's already at the top of my favorite. It is such a pretty highlighting shade. It's awesome. Then I'm gonna go in with my Maybelline matte lipstick in Daringly Nude, and I'm gonna be so honest with you guys, I thought that these were gonna be a complete failure of a lipstick, but I am so wrong. They are so great, and for drugstore lipstick, like, hello, can you go wrong? I don't think so. It's awesome. And then finally, I'm gonna dip my MAC 217 brush in my Shimma Shimma Makeup Geek eyeshadow. I needed a little bit of a light boost in the middle of my eyes, believe it or not. I was looking a little bit tired and it was a little bit depressing, but I'm just gonna be putting that there. And then after that, this look is complete. I really hope you guys liked it. I really loved filming this video. If you guys want to see another New Year's video or video of that sort, just let me know down in the comments, and make sure you guys go check out Lauren's video because she is awesome. She is honestly such a beautiful person in and out. Lauren, you're awesome. And I really hope that you guys all have a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holiday, Happy New Year, whatever you want to call it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!